That's step one, two, and three. That's the left side of the strategy A3. But then as we move to the right side, the do and then the study and adjust, as we move towards the do, there's a lot of this thing that we call catch ball that has to occur to help develop that. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, so our senior leadership team gets together during the summer months to prepare for our fiscal year that starts on October 1. And so we do that during the summer in preparation for the new fiscal year. The other important reason that we do it in the summer is because we need to do a lot of catch ball, and we need to do catch ball well. As an organization, one of the things that we really work on is how do we improve playing catch ball with the people that actually do the work. We believe that it is part of our principle-based system of having humility in what we do as leaders, and also showing respect for the people that do the work. So catch ball is a critical piece of strategy deployment and a critical piece of our management system. And what it means is just that we take these if-then statements or hypotheses that we've developed, and we take them to the people that do the work and say, so we think that if we do this, that we will do, that this will help close this much of the gap. What do you think about that? An interesting thing happens when you play catch ball. You get the engagement of the people that are doing the work, and sometimes you learn new things immediately. You learn that the gap, they believe that they can close a bigger piece of the gap if we will do other things. So what it does is it helps refine our thinking in our hypotheses, and it helps build the plan on the right side. So what are actually the activities that we do, the tactical plans that we will have to help close that strategic gap? Catch ball is critically important.
Really, really good. So the final piece of that is what our friend Pascal Dennis always calls the most important piece, the study and adjust. So that's built on the presupposition that everything that we've developed, something's wrong and that we just don't know what it is. So talk a little bit about the study and adjust piece.
This whole system is built on being able to align the organization and deploy a strategy. But the strategy is only as good as our ability to check and adjust that strategy as we move through the year. So the final piece is the most important. It's how are we gonna check ourselves and see where we are on this. So as you look at this board, we have a way to check in our management system. We have a way to check on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, and on a monthly basis. So at the organizational level, this is an activity we do on a monthly basis. But we'll also see activity done on a weekly basis and even on a daily basis to help close these strategic gaps. This bottom right box of check and adjust means what are those cadences and what are those activities that we do to ensure that we have leader standard work in our organization? And how are we gonna follow up on the items that we have? So our monthly meeting for strategy deployment is one way that we do that. Our weekly huddles are another way that we have follow-up to check and adjust our thinking. The other thing that I would say about check and adjust is that as we develop these strategic A3s, as we start into the fiscal year, these become static documents. The work really moves to the status A3 to have our check and adjust thinking for each period of the year. And so the status A3 is where the work really transpires, and we see that check and adjust on each one of these imperatives, on each one of these documents each month.
So that was really interesting how you explained that. So, you know, it's been said that a culture is made up of its routines and habits. And so if I understood you right, you have a monthly strategy meeting, which deploys work down to a weekly huddle board meeting that we'll learn about more later in other videos. And then that deploys and connects down to daily experimentation work. Is that correct?
Yeah, and let me use a specific example. We know that the patient experience is something that we want to work on to improve the right care for our patients. And so we have specific strategies on our status updates about how we're improving and how we're tackling improving the patient experience as judged by surveys that our patients fill out. So we have specific examples, and you see in the visual run chart, specific questions with the patient experience that we look at each month and we track and get updates on each month, and we take actions and we see what those actions gave each month in the patient experience. And we do that at a macro level for our organization here. And what we want to show is that connection to other parts, specifically at the department level, what they do and how they work on the patient experience and how that rolls up into this strategic deployment model.
Really good. So we have the strategy A3, we have the status A3, which ends up being the studying and adjusting, and then we have the visual management, the metrics that are helping us define our gap. Is that right?
Absolutely.
And so one of the things that we're going to see as we deploy down to the huddle boards is how this work is connected to that work. So at this point, now we're going to go to our huddle board meeting. That's a meeting that occurs every single week, and it's work that aligns itself to the safe room and to the strategic A3s. Now, what we have there is what we call tactical A3s. They're structured in the exact same way as the strategic A3. They're just at a department level.